My name is Leigh Orf, and I'm a scientist at the University of Wisconsin. I study thunderstorms. Specifically, I study the supercell thunderstorms that produce the most powerful tornadoes, using computers to simulate them. Only a small fraction of supercells produce tornadoes, and only a small fraction of that fraction produce the kind of tornado that we're trying to study. But the reason we're studying it is because, if you think of 2011 with Joplin, Missouri, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, El Reno, Oklahoma, these are the big, long-track EF5 tornadoes that do just incredible damage, and if people can't get out of the way of those storms, a lot of fatalities. A computer model, like the one we're using, essentially emulates or simulates the real atmosphere as faithfully as we scientists know how to make it work. We use the equations of physics to essentially grow a cloud in a specific environment. What goes into the model are atmospheric conditions of winds, temperature, pressure, and humidity. And from there on, it's just the model just integrates forward in time. This sequence is designed to give you a sense of the scale of the storm. Then what's really striking about this is you can see how small the tornado is, at least with respect to the full storm. But the reason I do this is to give people an understanding of why we need supercomputers to study this, because the whole storm really needs to be at this very high resolution in order to capture the tornado. This highlights the streamwise vorticity current, which is a feature we've identified in these simulations that seems to be important to maintaining the strength of the storm and therefore the tornado. So what we're doing is we're releasing parcels along the forward flank of the storm. So that's where the storm is going. These are just massless, we call them parcels, air parcels in meteorology. They take a horizontal path where they're rotating along a horizontal axis, and then they kind of go tilted upward into the storm's updraft. Depending upon where you put these source regions, you can see the air is doing very different things. The red region is the streamwise vorticity current. The darker green region, this is air that's in the cold pool of the supercell, and it seems to be directly feeding the tornado. And as you go to the yellow and the blues, you're going towards the rear of the storm. And things get a little less obvious as you head towards the rear of the storm. The whole reason we do this kind of research is essentially to produce better forecasts of when these things are going to happen. Too many people still die from tornadoes around the world, but in the United States too. We have a false alarm problem where we issue warnings when the tornado's not happening. And then we have a problem where the tornado's already happening, but we haven't issued a warning. So the challenge is to do a much better job at producing these warnings even before the storm has formed. And the first step is to first understand the storm. Before you can't forecast a storm until you understand it. And we're just getting to the point where we're better understanding what's going on.